Greetings one and all. So I thought I'd show you something kind of cool that my buddy Oregon Mike sent me. Thank you, Mike, by the way. You rock. You've seen my MSR Seagull before. The 1.1 liter, I believe. Love this thing. You know, it's what I bake Bannock in. But we got to talking about alcohol stoves, and he sent me a Trangia stove, which I've never used before, so I thought I'd bring it out, show it to you, and make some hot chocolate, which I have some here. So I got a couple other videos I'm working on too, so I figured, hey, I can have some hot chocolate while I do this, and I wanted to show you real fast. I've shown these little stove stands before. They're actually steamer racks. You know, this one was $1.79, and this one was $1.49. But if you notice, I mean, how excellent of a fit is that? If I can get the camera down lower. I mean, could you get a better fit? I mean, how perfect is that? That wasn't even planned because I had these stands, you know, well before the thing ever came along, and that is like great clearance. I could totally put my canteen on there. I mean, that just rocks. My cook pot, perfect fit. And it fits both of them just great. Or heck, even if I was boiling water for sanitation, I mean, it'd probably take a while to get it to a boil. But it's my 38 ounce guy bottle. Let's check that out. That is freaking cool. So I'm gonna get this fired up. Never used one before. I've got some, he also sent me some fuel. Clean strip alcohol, which I've never used before. So let's get cracking. So it says to open, pry it off, but good thing I have a multi-tool. It'd really suck if I messed it up. I am planning on getting a... Oh, there we go. Simple enough. I am planning on getting a little container to carry the fuel in, because I'm not going to carry the whole can, because that would be silly. And I don't know how much I'm going to need to boil hot chocolate, but... Put the lids on tight. Gonna use something I rarely use, my Strike Force. And there she goes. It's going, right? Oh. Get one out. I think it went out. A lot of fuel's gone too. I think maybe it absorbed in the sides. Make sure it's out before I pour more fluid in there, because that would be bad. I guess there's a bit of a learning curve since I've never used one before. It would have been really awkward if it had flared up just then. I think it's absorbing into the sides. Like I said, first time using it, so I've only seen it done on video. It's like all the fluid levels are dropping every time I put fluid in there, so I just need enough for to boil hot chocolate, so. A few of you guys might be out there screaming at the camera, "You're doing it wrong!" Hey. Not really sure what I'm doing here, guys. See the flame, so I wonder if you guys can see that. Yeah, I think you can. Oh yeah, it's putting off heat. Them out. Alright, so I guess I'll bring it back when it's boiling, or bring it back with an update. Alrighty, we have a real nice boil going. Real nice boil. I don't mean boil, I mean burn. We have a real nice burn going. It's burning really well. Man, that's badass, Mike. Thank you. I think I'm going to be able to use this while I'm out hiking a lot. So I won't have to worry about making a fire. I could just drop, set down the mug or the stove, fire it up, have a hot beverage. Which, you know, it's September now, so fall is coming. Sweet. All right, I'll bring it back. Starting to get some bubbles going. I found out, interesting, FYI, the stand will get hot. Found out the hard way. I want to just adjust it off the table here. Get the leg it slipped in. Moved it just a bit. Just a slight touch. I was like, ooh, that's warm. So, if you have a stand, word of the caution. I mean, I didn't get burned or anything, but if I wasn't thinking about it and I just like grabbed the stove like full on, yeah, that would have been a nasty burn. So good to know now. I think we almost have boil. Sweet. Alright. Alrighty, we have a boil. Plenty of enough boil for hot chocolate. Oh yeah. Be a great little warm drink on a rainy day. Rainy and overcast day. There you go. I still have a lot of fuel in there too. Alright, good to know. Maybe less fuel next time. Just burning along nicely. Nice big flame. It looks to be quite a bit of fuel down inside, so I don't know how long it's going to continue burning, but I've actually got another video I'm going to be doing right after this, so I did this first so it could finish boiling and then cool down so I could, you know, head home. Well, cool. Thanks again, Oregon Mike. I'll link this video, or I'll link his channel down below for you guys. Thanks for watching. You'll probably see this out on some day hikes now that the weather's getting foul, and man, warm drink on a cold day really hits the spot. Plus, I might be looking into more meal options as well, so now I have another way of boiling water. All right, take it easy. Hey, I wanted to show real quick. Look how hot this metal's gotten. You know, it's kind of red. It's cranking out some serious heat, so I'm curious to see how well this thing holds up after many uses, because it looks like it has a little weld spot right here. This, it's supposed to be a steamer rack, not really a stove stand, so I'd be really curious to see how long it stays. It should be fine though. Still got a bit of fuel in there too. I might have put too much in. But I guess I could try to snuff it, see how that works. Ooh. Wow, it doesn't want to blow out very easy, does it? Huh, there it goes. Good to know. Probably don't want to touch that for the life of me. Probably burn the crap out of my hands. Alright, decided to check back in. See ya. Okay, I guess I wasn't quite finished, but I was, it's been a little bit since I filmed, but I was shooting another video actually. But I wanted to kind of show. I still got some fluid in here. I don't know if you guys can see it. Yeah, I guess you can. And this thing is nice and cool to the touch. So, but I don't know if this. So I got the O-ring here. Of course, it's going to be stubborn. And I'm wondering if it will leak out. Let's see. Well, I guess it won't. What's really nice too is like this thing will fit perfectly in here. One nice contained package. It's got a little bit of rattle, but you know, what are you gonna do? Alright, just wanted to throw that last little part in there. I wonder if I could find another way to. I do have some more room in here though. I could probably. Well, I guess it's this part that's rattling. I could probably put another bandana in there and keep it from rattling, but. I know, we'll see. A little rattle never killed anybody. So.